Welcome to my channel Medical Laboratory Technologist Videos. Today I am going to discuss with you an important topic, that what is the difference between HIV and AIDS. It can be easily to confuse HIV and AIDS. They are different diagnoses but they go hand in hand. So today we will discuss in this lecture what is the difference between HIV and AIDS, because as a lab technician and as a lab technologist you should know the difference between HIV and AIDS, so that you can tell to common person also if they will ask from you what is the difference between HIV and AIDS. And if you want to see this lecture in local language like Hindi or Urdu, you can use the other video that is already available in the cards of that video, that you can see in Hindi translation, that what is the difference between HIV and AIDS. Now we will start the lecture and I will tell you to memorize that what is the difference between HIV and AIDS term. Now we will start that what is the difference between HIV and AIDS. HIV is a virus that can lead to a condition called AIDS, also known as stage 3 HIV. It means that the patient, if infected with HIV, it doesn't mean that he is in the condition of AIDS. It will take time to reach the condition or to reach the stage 3 HIV. So it is not necessary that every HIV patient will develop the condition of AIDS. There are the cases now, as we know that science and medicine treatments are more progressed. So if a patient is taking properly treatment, then he have the good survival. So most of the time HIV patients will not develop the condition AIDS. But if a person will reach to the condition of AIDS, it's sure that he have HIV virus. So from this main difference we can understand that every HIV patient have HIV virus, but it is not necessary that he can lead to the condition of AIDS. If he is taking properly treatment, then there is a rare chance that he will lead to the stage 3 HIV. So HIV is a virus, but AIDS is known as a condition, that is stage 3 HIV. So first we will discuss that HIV is a virus. So now I will give you a little description or summary form that what is HIV. The term HIV stands for human immunodeficiency virus. Now you can see that HIV stands for human immunodeficiency virus. From this detailed name you can understand three important points. That first, human, it means that virus will infect humans. Second is immunodeficiency, means it will affect the immune system of the human. And third is virus, means the cause of this infection or disease is called virus. So the term human immunodeficiency virus, as the name describes, the cause is virus. And HIV is a virus that can lead to human system deterioration, means it will specially infect the human immune system and it will destroy the human immune system. So this virus will affect or target the immune system. So now I will discuss you the structure and family or genes of the HIV virus. HIV virus is the member of genes lentivirus and the family is part of family of retroviridae, and by structure it is single-stranded enveloped RNA virus. If you know the classification of viruses, you know there is classification based on single-stranded, double-stranded, enveloped, non-enveloped RNA, DNA. So HIV is single-stranded enveloped RNA and part of family retroviridae and genes lentivirus family. So as I discussed, the HIV virus will infect the human immune system. So to which immune system is main target of HIV virus? HIV virus infect vital cells, mean the most important cell in the human immune system, such as helper T cells. As we know, the T cells are the type of lymphocytes, and lymphocytes is the major type of WBCs, white blood cells or leukocytes. So it means HIV infect the T cells, and in T cells also there are different type of T cells in our body that are playing important role in our immune system. So In that T cell specifically, HIV will target CD4 plus T cells and macrophages and dendritic cells. HIV infection can lead to the low level of CD4 cells. So from this point, you can understand that if a person have HIV, then it is necessary to monitor their CD4 plus cells to see either the patient is recovering or if he is losing HIV CD4 cells, it means he is leading to the condition called AIDS or stage 3 HIV. So when CD4 T cell member decline below the critical level, cell mediated immunity will lost and leading to the development of AIDS. So now you can understand HIV is virus and that can lead to a condition called AIDS. So if a person will diagnose with HIV, it is not necessary that he have AIDS also. It will take the time to develop the condition of AIDS. Now we will study about the condition called AIDS, what means. Now we will discuss that what is AIDS, or AIDS is a, as we discussed before, AIDS is a condition. First, you have to know AIDS stands for. AIDS stands for acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. It means it develop, the syndrome means there is more sign and symptoms and infection that will develop and that are related to each other. That's why we will tell us, or we will say that AIDS stands for acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Normally, as we know, as just I've discussed before, that HIV is a virus, and in that virus that will target the T cells of body, and in T cells specifically it will target CD4 cells, and we will monitor the if the patient is diagnosed with HIV, we will monitor the CD4 level to observe how is the progress of disease in that patient. Normally CD4 cells, if the person without HIV, there will be 500 to 1200 CD4 cells, but when a patient diagnosed with HIV, CD4 cells will level will decrease. And as I discussed before, that when it will when it will reach or it will decline the critical range, it means when CD4 cells will be less than 200, it means now the HIV patient is leading to the condition called AIDS or stage 3. It means that when the HIV patient develops stage 3, it means they have less than 200 CD4 cells. It is a complex condition with symptoms that vary from person to person. Means the person who developed the stage 3, their symptoms are not related or not same with each AIDS patient. You will observe there are different symptoms each AIDS patient will show depending upon at that time what type of infection that patient developed. And the severity of the infection, because as we discussed, the AIDS patient, the immune system will be totally near to destroyed. So body is not able to recover from infection. Mostly the symptoms that patients will show for HIV that include tuberculosis and pneumonia. And now at the end of this lecture, I will tell you how HIV will transmit from person to person through exchange of body fluids. Means without screening you are taking any person blood or any type of body fluid, there is a chance that you can take HIV blood also. So must need to be screened patient. Viral screening is must need before any type of exchange of body fluids. Other more common and the major cause is the sex and share needles. Share needles means you can share the same blood needles, or the needles used for drug sharing is also the common cause of transmission of HIV. There is a less common cause that mother can transmit the virus to their child during pregnancy. So this is the lecture. I told you the difference between HIV and AIDS. I hope now you understand what is the difference between HIV and AIDS. HIV is the virus and AIDS is the condition. Thank you so much. Have a bright future to all of you.